Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm writing a book on one God, one faith, in which I will be introducing both of these anointed sons of God. This is chapter 12. Which is on Swastika and the four edges. Swastika is a religious symbol which represents the cycle of ages, four cycle. And we are in the last age, which is called Dark Age. And after atomic war, then the beginning will start, when it will be the golden age, Satyuga we call it. Everybody living in peace, in the harmony with our Father God. No way to earn treasures of God. This is the best age to earn your salvation. So here it is. Thus in Mammon, empires were established, and so the custom of buying and selling of the goods. So at that time, you know, Abraham was made to move from his hometown to this Middle East to establish a new generation of chosen people with promised land. Promised land given by Yahweh. So Shri Ramchandraji and Moses, the lawmakers, are Muryada Parshotam Avtars, were the first prophets to teach the moral laws based upon the solid roots of oral Torah, or his word. That is, Moses put on Christ and wrote the scriptures. They stressed upon the qualities of mercy. Such prophets are said to be the reincarnation of Vishnu, the preserver of humanity. For being perfect in works, the people of this age were called angels or Devtas. They were very, whatever they were told, they would do it, you know, without any hitch. They were wise men, capable of handling their political affairs efficiently. So they were right here, you know, the wise men. And so they are of this category, wise men here. These are clever people, they come in this dark age. These are simpletons, they will come in the next age. I will describe Dwapar Yug. And this is Sat Yug, which is after the atomic war. All people will be saint. Beginning. There was no worship of idols, but as the age degraded, people became less knowledgeable, twice born, and more natural, once born men. The simpletons, they increased in number. Number of twice born decreased. Then the idol worship started, and Brahmins used to teach the moral laws through mythological idols like that of Ganesh with elephant nose. They have got elephant nose. If you ask these people, you know, who are Brahmins, why he has elephant nose, they have no idea. They will tell you the story behind it, but not the moral. The moral is this, that whenever you want to do an important work or occasion, we call it Shubh Karma, that whenever you want to do a good deed, like marriage ceremony or any other, you know, which is a very important, in which your family honor is at stake, then you worship Ganesh, it reminds you of your family nose. that don't do anything wrong, which you get it cut. So to remind you of the family nose, they worship Ganesh that has the longest nose. And that is the moral behind it. But they will tell you all that story, but it leads to the same thing. Now the next age is called Dwapar Age, which is Brass Age or Dwapar Age, Yug. The era of moon with one-third light. One-third light, only truth remains. You have the shame plus truth. In this age, most people had become devoid of mercy and contentment also. Thus, their love for Maya, material things, increased. And they, being mostly once born, could not understand the holy books. Brahmins, rabbis also became less efficient, and they could not control their congregations as well. People became egoistic, boastful, and loved to see their own relatives in a poor state than themselves. To a simple man, you know, his own wisdom and the other man's wealth looks big. So that is what they are, jealous of. Jealousy prevails. Bodybuilding and gambling was prevalent among the simpletons, but they lacked the political understanding. Thus, Pandav lost their land and even their common wife, Draupadi, in the gambling contest to their cousins, Kauravas. And to humiliate the Pandavas, the Kauravas tried to disgrace Draupadi by undressing her publicly, but Shri Krishna Baldevji, the prophet of Dwapar Yug, the lord of nature, protected her honor, called Pat. Pat means honor in Punjabi. So Krishna Baldevji, as implied in his name, Krishna means ray of light, Baldev means devta of might. Bal means power, Dev means devta. He was the incarnation of Shiva. And for this reason, he is called Niti Parshotam Avtar, where Niti stands for political policies. Parshotam, the seer, or a person who guides you. Avtar stands for prophet. People, being simpletons, they could not resolve the political issues. So they could not resolve the political issues with their close relatives. So they sought the help of Shri Krishna Baldevji. Krishna urged them to fight for their rights. But they did not want to fight with their close relatives. Then Krishna assured them that there is nothing wrong in fighting for your rights and to kill the guilty person. Krishna showed Pandu his real self, that he is the lord of nature, Mahadeva or Shiva, and all the subjects of nature belong to him. So Krishna opened his mouth, and through them he showed them that men, animal, everything coming from his mouth. So he is the lord of the nature. Then they gave a good fight and won the battle of righteousness. If you remember that the favorite name of Krishna was Govinda, then you should know that royal king Satyapasha, we call him Satyapasha, Govinda Raiji was his counterpart in supernatural father god, or incarnation of Par Shiv. More on this topic in the four communities of religion. By the end of this age, most of the rabbis, Brahmins, had become corrupt, but the sensible rabbis, Brahmins, left this topmost profession. Sorry. Hello? Yeah, yeah. Huh? Yeah, aunty there, yeah. Just hold on. Yeah. Leave me again. Sorry for the break, telephone call. So by the end of this age, most of the rabbis, Brahmins, had become corrupt, but the sensible rabbis, Brahmins, left this topmost profession, in which 9 out of 10 religious qualities are perfected, for the second best farming profession, in which 8 are perfected. So my father has done the analysis on this one, and I will put that 10 qualities which you the spirit, gift of spirit, that you should have for perfection. Hope this next I will be starting with Iron Age, the Dark Age, which is this present age. So you can see how the things changed, and the rabbis became useless, and that is why people were left unshepherded, no shepherd for them, no person to guide them. And those who were seeking truth, they could not find any. So that's why our Father God sent his own Son in this dark age. No more prophets. Prophets were for rabbis to pull their ears, do things wrong. But as the pulling of the ears was not enough, you know, so the rabbis became corrupt. So the only way was to send his own Son to give direct knowledge of his word to the general public at large. That's why the Advent candle are 4 in number, because there are 4 varnas, 4 professions, which are laborers, once born, twice born, they are the businessmen and politicians, and then those who do the job of rabbis or Brahmin, they go for wilderness, as John the Baptist did, and they are purely spiritual, and they oversee the works of the people. It is I'm giving you just gist, you know, for proper understanding, we need to have a close discussion with each other so you can understand it. So if you understand, say, 70% what I'm talking about, then you are a lucky man.